Hello, dear students. Today we are going to see how to prepare nutrient stab and nutrient slant. So the aim of the practical is to prepare and sterilize nutrient stab and nutrient slant. The requirements are broth culture of E. coli. And the apparatus required is test tube, marker, and Nichrome loop. The equipment required is autoclave and incubator. So the principle of the experiment is the agar slope is known as the slant. It is the test tube containing solidified agar whose solidification is done by tilting the test tube at an angle of about 30 degrees Celsius. This gives an agar slope surface which can be easily inoculated with the loop. And agar plate has a disadvantage of large area is exposed to contamination. So agar slope is advantageous in the sense that it has low surface area exposed to contamination, but sufficient surface area for growth, and growth takes place on the surface only. So what is the principle of stab? That is, it is sometimes necessary to remove free oxygen from the culture during the growth, as some microbes show retarded growth by exposure to oxygen. So this type of microorganism can be cultivated readily in depth of the solid media by agar stab technique. Agar stab is nothing but the tube containing agar medium which is allowed to stand in vertical position for solidification. When the agar is hard, the medium is inoculated deeply with the help of sterilized medium. These two methods can be used as method of preservation. So now we will see the procedure.
Hello students. Now today we are going to prepare nutrient slant and nutrient stab. So aim for today's practical is to prepare nutrient stab and nutrient slant. Now these two are one of the methods used for the subculturing of the bacteria. So in the previous video you have seen how we have performed the subculturing on the agar plate. In this practical we are going to see how to perform the subculturing of the bacteria using this slant and stab. So why we are using this slant and stab? It is most widely used technique for the preservation using subculturing technique, because in agar plate the surface area is very large, and because of which there is a possibility of contamination inside the agar plate during the subculturing. While in case of the slant and stab, we are preparing the culture in the test tube. So that is the reason why the surface area which is exposed for the contamination is less in case of the slant and stab. So what is the difference between slant and stab? In case of the slant, we have to solidify agar in the slanting position, while in case of the stab, we have to keep the test tube upright. Okay. Now stab technique. It is performed or it is used to remove the oxygen which is present in the medium. Okay, because some microbes they show retarded growth in presence of oxygen. So we will see the procedure, you will come to know. So first of all, again you have to sterilize the platform using alcohol. Then you have to prepare two agar tubes, that is one tube which will be used for the slant preparation and one tube it will be used for the stab preparation. Okay. Then after you have prepared the agar tubes, then we have to keep one test tube in the slanting position. So when you will keep this in the slanting position, you will get the agar solidified in the form of a slant. Okay. So the second tube will be like this. Okay. More will be the slanting position, more will be the surface area which is available for the inoculation. Okay. So if your test tube, you are placing it likewise, okay, here you can see the surface which is available for the streaking is very high. Okay. So that is the principle of slant. So we have to prepare agar, slant and stem. So for that I have kept one test tube in the slanting position and one test tube in the upright position. Okay. Now next is you have to do the inoculation. For the inoculation you have to sterilize the nitromyer loop and then you have to perform the streaking. Okay. Now how to perform streaking in slant and stem? So first we'll see how to perform streaking in agar slant. Okay. So here you have taken a test tube containing the agar slant. So agar slant, it will be having the surface like this. When you will see from the top, the surface will be like this. Okay. So after you have sterilized with nitromyer loop, you will take the bacterial culture on the nitromyer loop. And then you will take that culture, that is the nitromyer loop containing the bacterial culture, and then you will streak it in a zigzag manner on the surface of the agar slant. Okay, when you will streak it in this manner, your agar slant is ready for incubation. Okay, in case of agar stem, what you have to do after you have taken the bacterial culture on the nitromyer loop, this is your agar stack tube. Okay. When the media will get solidified, you have to directly stab the nitromyer loop inside the media. So what will happen? The whatever is the oxygen bubbles which may cause the hindrances during the growth of the bacteria, that will be prevented. Okay, so this is known as the stab technique. Directly you have to stab inside the test tube. Okay, so this is the way by which you will streak in the agar slant and in the agar stem. Okay, after this you have to incubate it. Depending on the bacterial sample you are using, we are using the E. coli sample. So we will incubate this at 30 to 35 degrees Celsius. Okay, so this is the procedure for how to perform or how to prepare nutrient slant and nutrient stem. Now we will see the practical, that how we can perform it. The very first step while performing the practical is to sterilize the platform. So now this is the platform where I am going to perform the practical. So first of all, I have thoroughly cleaned the platform, here you can see. And now I will disinfect it using the alcohol. So here you can see I have used the ethanol. So I will take a small portion of the cotton. And then I will take ethanol and disinfect the platform where I have to perform the practical. Make sure your burners are off while performing this disinfection process, otherwise the alcohol can catch the fire. So just clean the platform properly and allow the alcohol to evaporate. Now here you can see the alcohol has vaporized and this section is completely sterilized. Now we will need to maintain the sterilized air. That is, the air environment should be sterilized. So For that, I will switch on the burners. And now I will perform the practical in between these two burners. So whatever my requirements are, or if you require test tube, I will place in between these two burners. So complete sterile environment will be maintained in between these two burners, and then I will perform the practical here. Now we are going to see how we are going to pour the agar in the test tube and how we are going to prepare the culture dish. This is the sterilized test tube we have taken, and now we will see how to prepare the agar tubes, that is agar slant and stem. So now I have taken these two test tube. In one test tube I am going to prepare the agar stem, and in other test tube I am going to prepare agar slant. Okay, so this I have unwrapped this sterilized test tube. Now this is agar which is cooled at room temperature. I will remove the cotton of both the tubes, whether it is a culture tube. I will frame it and I will remove the cotton of the culture flask and I will frame it. And near to the burner, I will just pour the agar. So as per the requirement you can pour it. Flame this flask. Apply the cotton. Flame this tube and apply the cotton. Make sure the cotton should not be kept down, otherwise it will cause the contamination. So there is a possibility that by performing the practical you will remove this and place it on the platform, it will cause contamination. So that should be kept in mind, that the cotton should not be kept down, it should be kept in hand only. So this is my stab. I am placing it in upright position. Now I am taking this test tube and now I will perform the same operation. Now this test tube I am preparing for the slant. Flaming is very necessary, otherwise there is a possibility of contamination. Now in case of slant, I will slightly tilt the test tube and place it in slanting position. So here you can see the slant will be prepared. Now I am allowing them to solidify. Now here you can see the stab is ready. Now we will, this is the slant and this is the stab, it is ready. Now we will inoculate the solidified agar with the E. coli organism. This is the test tube containing the bacterial sample of the E. coli. So first we will take the inoculum of the E. coli. Now I will sterilize this nichrome wire loop. Flame the neck of the culture tube. Take the bacterial sample. Again flame the neck and apply the cotton. Then I will take this slant, flame the neck, and now with the help of this nichrome wire loop, I will streak in a zigzag manner on the surface of the slant. Again I will flame it and apply the cotton. So my slant is now ready. Again I will take the bacterial sample for this stamp. In case of stash, I will remove the cotton, flame it, and directly I will insert this nichrome wire loop within the solid medium. So this is the stab technique. Again I will flame it and apply the cotton. Plant and the stem is ready. Now I will place this in incubator for incubation. In incubator I have set the temperature to 35.3 degrees Celsius. So now I will place these tubes in the incubator once this temperature is reached. Now the temperature has reached to 35 degrees Celsius. Now we will place it in incubator for 24 to 48 hours. And observe the growth.
I hope you have understood the procedure. So we will quickly see the procedure. That is, take two sterilized test tube, add molten agar into the test tube and allow one test tube to stand in vertical position and another test tube to align at 30 degree. After solidification, inoculate the test tube with the bacterial culture. For this, sterilize the nichrome wire loop and take the inoculum. To prepare slant, flame the culture tube and insert the loop inside the test tube and streak the slant surface in a zigzag manner. Reflame the tube and apply cotton. Prepare stab, flame the second test tube and insert the loop containing the bacterial sample directly into the medium. Again, reflame the tube and apply the cotton. Incubate both the tubes at 35 to 37 degrees Celsius for 24 to 48 hours. So here you can see This is tab and this is slant. So observation, in case of the slant, the growth is observed likewise, while in case of this tab, the growth is observed likewise and there is some sediment also. So growth is observed in both the test tubes. That will be the observation. So result is nutrients, tab and slant were prepared and incubated. So questions they can ask is, what is nutrient slant? What is nutrient tab? Write applications of slant and tab. That's all. Okay. So thank you, students, for listening. I hope you have understood this practically.